Cooper Webb, and I choose OGO.
I'm Christian Craig.
I'm Dean Wilson.
I'm Aaron Plessinger.
I'm Darren Martin.
I'm Nate Thrasher.
I'm Shane McElrath.
I'm Hunter Lawrence.
My name's Jared Lawrence.
I'm Jordan Smith.
I'm Talon Hawkins.
Stargate Hampshire.
I'm Hayden Deegan.
I'm Colt Nichols.
And I choose OGO.
And I choose OGO.
And I choose OGO.
I'm Tom Bial. I choose OGO.
And I choose OGO.
And I choose OGO.
I'm Jiren Ferrangis.
And I choose OGO.
Honestly, I've had better days, I'll be real with you guys. I was happy to qualify in the mud this morning. We were 26th overall, and there was another smoke out there with me too, with Lesher, so that was cool that both of us qualified in good. And then first moto, it wasn't going great. I had a little fall, but I was still charging. And then I've never had this happen before, but my bike started detonating and make a bunch of noise, so we were having problems with the piston. I kind of thought I was done for the day, and then my crew and a bunch of people that walked by, everybody rallied together and helped me get it changed in like 45 minutes in between motos. So we thought we were back in it, and then second moto had another first lap crash like an idiot, and was coming back through. Actually, I felt like I was riding pretty good, and then I think when we were changing the motor, I think maybe some dirt fell in the carb or something, and the float got stuck because I landed off a tabletop back there, and she just hung wide open on me, and there was nothing wrong with the throttle. It was just, yeah, I've never had anything like that happen before, so I'm fairly certain we got last, but we live to fight another day, and we've made 4 for 4 so far. So, I mean, how mad can I really be?
Dude, you're like the little brother in motocross, switching motos, but engines between motos. It's tight.
Yeah, I mean, luckily it was a two-stroke. If it was a four-stroke, I would have had no chance. But I definitely wouldn't have been able to do it without my crew, the super fan, Chris Maynard, my suspension guy, and then KMS Factory, Phil. They all banded together to help me get that thing done. I can't believe how quick they got it together, because I was even thinking maybe we shouldn't do it and just go get my money to make sure I didn't miss the moto. But they told me they could do it, so I trusted them, and they got it done quick. It was awesome.
Okay, East Coast guy, how was that track out there today?
It was gnarly. I'll be real with you guys. I've never seen anything like that before. Just with all the rain and how soft it was this morning, the ruts were like I've never seen before. Like, we just walked on the track after the motos were over so I could show my family, and it's just insane. Like, I don't even understand how we were riding it. But I do love the East Coast soft dirt. I wish the motos were more like qualifying, because the qualifying was muddy as can be, and I kind of like that. So maybe we'll get a rain one of these times, but I am stoked to be back east. The dirt's nice and soft. We had a lot of sawdust, which was a little bit weird for High Point, but we're back on the East Coast and we're loving it.
Oh boy, how was today? Well, not ideal again. Anything outside of top 10 for me is not a good weekend. I went 14-10 for 12th overall, I believe. Moto number one, I stalled the bike early on, and I didn't get started right off the bat. So came from last, I think last at least. I don't think I had anyone behind me, but from last to 14th. So considering that, like, I rode decent. Then second moto, I was running ninth for quite a while, and then Marchbanks got me at the end, and ended up 10. So a little bit of a better moto, but you know, overall, like, I'm not stoked on it. Last weekend was a little bit of a rough weekend as well. So two good but rough weekends, I guess, in a sense. It's been consistent this year, I guess. 12th overall is my worst in four races. So just really looking to step it up going forward. I'm looking forward to going to the sandier base type of track. So Red Bud's gonna be a lot of fun. It's mainly what I ride at Club MX. It's kind of a sandier type of base. And just getting some more time on the bike and some more testing will be good as well. So, but yeah, overall, not stoked on today.
So when I used to race, terrible C-class rider, and I'd fall in the first turn, my dad would always be like, yeah, then you did your best moto because, like, you choked, and then you got all the pressure out of the way. Is that what these motos feel like when you have an early lap issue and then you just rip through and then get to the top 10, top 15? Because to pass 25, 35 dudes, you're on a mission.
I would say maybe a little bit to some degree. I would say I used to feel more like that when I was younger. Now I don't necessarily anymore. Like, I'm comfortable racing up front with the all the other factory guys. So I don't necessarily feel that pressure anymore. Though, I mean, I put a lot of pressure on myself. I think all of us riders do to perform. So we always want to perform, but in general, not necessarily. But yeah, I used to maybe put on some really good rides if I fell right off the back, because you didn't have anything to lose, I guess, to put it that way. But
when you're coming through the pack, like, what do you think about? Are you watching line stuff? Like, how much are you really taking into everything? Or is it just like, oh, there's a guy. Oh, there's an opportunity to pass. Oh, there's another one.
Yeah, so, like, I would say for me, coming through the pack, I will maybe try to alter my lines a little bit to some degree. But at the end of the day, I need to get points. So I'm certainly thinking about going forward. I need to pick off riders, more and more riders. So at the end of the day, it's a long season with a lot of motos. But it could come down to, you know, having your best season yet or not on a couple points. So, you know, it's really, I don't want to waste any time on the track, to put it that way. So if I see a guy, I'm certainly going to, I'm going to charge to the checkered, to put it that way. Try to get each and every guy I can and just get as many points as possible.
It was good. I mean, second moto didn't go our way, but yeah, throughout practice, I was buried first moto, came up back up to ninth, and you know, the second moto started out strong. I just got behind Cooper and like, all right, it's gonna be a good moto. I'm just gonna latch onto him and finish it out. And had a clutch issue with my handguard kind of getting wedged in the clutch. So I was slipping super bad. I was rolling the clutch back and didn't realize that was the issue until I got back. So clutch went out, second moto. So how to just survive out there and bring it home to the checker.
Yeah, this is not a track you don't want to not have a clutch.
Yeah.
Yikes.
Yeah, it was very, very difficult riding out here with no clutch. I was trying very hard not to stall it and keep my momentum through the rides as much as I can. So it was very demanding not having a clutch for sure.
Are you a guy that does no clutch motos at the practice track?
Yes, I have definitely done no clutch motos. I mean, not that much, but it's nothing new.
You kind of talked about it latching up with Cooper and just seeing what's happening. Mm-hmm. How has this learning experience been for you this summer? I mean, you have the guys that are right there in front of you.
Yep.
You're dicing it up with them. You're learning a bike. This is huge for a young guy.
Yeah, it's really fun. I mean, Thunder Valley had two good starts and battled those guys a little bit, especially in qualifying. I enjoy qualifying, putting a lap together. So I just need two motos to go my way, and it'll be a big step in the right direction.
A lot of adversity. I mean, fell down three times first moto, got fifth. Second moto, fell down on the opening lap, got seventh. So pretty bummed on those mistakes. But no, I mean, there's a lot of good positives. The track was really, really gnarly and stuff. Still learning the 450, but no, it was good. Just, I mean, I don't fall down four times at home ever, so a little bummed on that. But yeah, clean that up, be good.
What was that track like today? I mean, completely different from start to finish. First thing this morning, super sloppy. Out there right now, concrete, hard pack, super deep ruts. Take me through it.
Yeah, the track was changing all day. It was really crazy. I mean, it was changing every lap. It was just really crazy how much it was changing. The bottom was getting super hard packed. So first moto, I was on the paddle. It was hard to tell if that was better. And then second moto, switched over to the 33. So yeah, it was just so hard pack on the bottom, like in the ruts, it would be like concrete. And then next section would be bottomless mud. So yeah, you really had to adjust on the track everywhere. So yeah, a lot of adversity with the track. Track was really gnarly, but overall, pretty good day.
Did you see the tie point sign when you came up the in the back? Did you see the tie point sign?
The what?
The tie point. So you didn't see the fan?
Yeah.
Some fan made a black sign, and it has 81, and it says tie point on it.
No way.
Yeah, yeah.
That's awesome. I didn't even see it.
Oh, man, that sucks. Yeah, dude, that's cool because, like, East Coast fans, you know, they get into it. They really like the spray paint and the, all that. That was cool to see somebody psyched for you today. Like,
oh, yeah. That, it's awesome. I mean, just the amount of fans. I don't like calling them fans. Like, my family to me, and just the amount of people that reached out to me in the last week. Very grateful for that, and, yeah, it's awesome. Really looking forward to Redbud and stuff and this week off to get a good training block in. But, yeah, big shout-out to all the fans.
Honestly, this is my career best day. I'm super pumped on how everything went today. You know, qualified my best in the 450 class, P3. Won the Moto 1, had a killer start, started second, and invaded the third. Followed Kenny for most of that race, and, you know, he got away from me, that one and two guy. And, you know, I just kind of rode by myself in third for a bit. Kenny made a mistake with two laps to go and managed to get a second place.
What's that feel like? Like, I mean, you knew you were top three the whole time, but then just like, yo, dude, I did it.
Yeah, honestly, like, I haven't podiumed in a long time, even though I didn't get the overall podium. You know, just to be up there on the box for Moto is amazing. You know, it's been a long time, 2 years, I believe. And, you know, for me to get my first ever podium, Moto podium, and outdoors on a 450, I'm super excited for that.
You haven't had the best luck at this track, huh?
No. My first 2 years, I ended.
You ended on the same spot, huh?
Yeah, rollers. I about did it today too, but yeah, we pulled out of it.
I'm psyched for you, dude. Even as that whole first moto was happening, I was like, hell yeah, Garrett, because I know this track has been very difficult for you. So this was good to see.
Yeah, I'm super pumped on it. Honestly, I've had two of my career best motos in the lights and 450 here. So today, beat it by quite a bit, so I'm super pumped on it.
Highs and lows of a racetrack, I like it. What do you do with this week off? More time on the 450, just shake it down more?
I think we're gonna just dial in the bikes more. We only had 4 days on the bike, so we're gonna keep testing some stuff and hopefully dial it in a little bit more, so when we come to Red Bud, we're even better.
Today on High Point, it was awesome. Brutal track to come back to for my first motocross race, but it didn't disappoint. We put up a really good battle in the first moto. Obviously the track was super deep, muddy, and then hard underneath it. It was gnarly. And I went down with about a lap and a half to go, which was a bummer, but I was on an uphill and couldn't really find neutral. It definitely cost me some time and ended up that first moto in seventh. And then came back for a second one, and I wanted to leave it all out on the track, which is exactly what I did. We ripped the whole shot and I was leading for a bunch of laps, and I feel like my line, I was ripping in the beginning, but my line choice wasn't really the greatest on certain parts on the track, and I feel like that cost me. So once Jet passed me, I kind of copied some of that, and Dylan was pushing me really hard as well, but I held on for second and ended up getting on the second overall on the podium with a seventh and a second, which is kind of crazy, and I couldn't be more stoked.
You know, you've been talking about this lately, just perspective on racing and everything like that last couple years. Every time you have a good finish or a win, you really, really celebrate it. Knowing that this is like one off and you may do a couple more later on this year, how much fun was today?
Today was incredibly fun, but that's kind of like been my mindset throughout Supercross season as well. I love working with the team. I'm really happy what we can do with the bike in very, very short amount of time. You know, that's never been the case in the years past, and I'm really happy with that. So I think that definitely adds to the fun factor when it comes to racing, and we got a lot of good feedback from the fans, and I think we came here to try and mix it up a little bit because the racing has been kind of boring, right? And I think that's exactly what we did, so I couldn't be more stoked.
Last thing, dude, you know, you've had it at every level. Championship contender, race your way into your career, everything like that. How it is right now, how fun is racing and like just the perspective you've got on it?
Racing is absolutely amazing right now, and I think what adds to that is just, first off, being with a great team and riding a motorcycle that's fun for me to ride. But my family, like Court loves racing, and my son, you know, we gave him the ultimatum of if he wants to go to the beach or racing, and he clearly said racing, and see his eyes sparkle. Even I took him on the podium, and he just knows what's going on. He got this adrenaline rush and he was screaming on the podium and showing the rock and roll. I mean, it makes it all worth it.